Anyone who knows me knows that I'm pretty much an uber Facts of Life fan. So in 1986, when Mrs. Garrett made the leap from Eastland to an all-girls school for witches in a movie called The Worst Witch, well, it's no surprise that that movie instantly became one of my favorite Halloween movies. So today I'm paying tribute to her characters, the Cackle sisters, with these vegan Halloween cackle apples. There are candy apples and caramel apples at every turn this time of year, which are delicious, but when I decided to make something from my favorite 80s Halloween movie, The Worst Witch, I wanted to do something a little bit more special, like a white chocolate covered apple. And of course it would be vegan, and as most of you vegans know, finding good vegan white chocolate is not an easy thing to do. But I think I did it. Here they are. These chips are sweet, they're easily melted, they're kosher, and they're vegan, and they're delicious. I'll put a link down below so that you can find them too, and you can make as many cackle apples as you want. Now, as far as my apples go, I am using Granny Smith. Two reasons. One, the tart taste goes really well with the nice sweet of the chips. I also really dig the color because once our chocolate chips are melted, we're gonna tint it pink. And pink and green is probably one of my favorite color combinations. Okay, to prepare your apples, pull out all the stems. You'll also wanna give them a good wash in some hot water because if there's any waxy coating on these things, it's gonna be really tough for the chocolate to stick to the apples. I like to do my cackle apples in small batches, so half a cup of chips is going to be perfect for 1 to 2 small apples. I'm also going to add just a little bit of coconut oil. That's going to make the chocolate nice and silky smooth when we dip our apples. Okay, this is going to go into the microwave for 1:20 to 1:40 seconds, but you're going to stop it every 20 seconds to give it a little bit of a stir. So a little more now on the famous cackle that we've named our apples after. Good. This is hard. Ugh. All right, so Mrs. Cackle was played by Charlotte Rae, who was also Mrs. Garrett on The Facts of Life. Mrs. Cackle was the headmistress at the school for witches. Now, Miss Cackle also had an evil twin witch sister who was named Agatha Cackle, and Agatha had bright pink hair, which is why we're gonna add a little pink to our white chocolate apples. I know it's fun to pull out the food coloring this time of year because we want our pumpkin cookies to be super orange and we want our Frankenstein cupcakes to be really green, but I actually stay away from this stuff as much as possible. So when I needed something bright pink, I turned to my stash of go-to items that usually turn things pink for me in a natural way. I have beet juice here. Well, as we all know, white chocolate is not really white. So when I added the beet juice, it turned a little gray, and I don't want gray cackle apples. Pomegranate juice almost always does the trick for me. I add this to icings for cookies and cupcakes, and it turns really nice red, pinky kind of color. This just made my chocolate clump up, and I don't want clumpy chocolate. So I went with this one. It's an all-natural food dye made from vegetables. I got it at the grocery store, and it works really well. The only thing is this little thing is about $5, and that's pretty expensive for a food dye. It actually came in a kit of 3, and the kit was about $15 or $16, so I go sparingly with this stuff. But for my cackle apples, I really wanted to go all out, and this is gonna do the trick to get my chocolate pink. Our white chocolate is out of the microwave and looking really good. 3 to 5 drops of red food coloring and we are good to go. Agatha's hair, of course, was electric pink, but I think this nice soft pink is gonna work just fine, especially because it was dyed with something natural and I know there's nothing harmful in here. Okay, it's time to dip the apple. We've all done this before. Just dip your apple in, swirl it around, and see how nice that coats? Now, I also have a knife kind of like on the side here, just in case this didn't coat so well. You can easily take a knife, dip it in the chocolate, and practically ice your apple as if you were icing a cupcake. You can see here there's like a little bald spot. Well, I'm just gonna take my knife and swirl it around. I like how it kind of clings to the apple all around and looks a little swooshy. Very natural looking, and look how nice it looks against the green of the apple. Okay, just put this on a plate after you're done and you're satisfied with how much chocolate is on your apple. Put it on a plate, let it set for a little bit, and it'll be just fine. You can also pop it into the fridge and it'll harden up nice and quick.
Yeah.
I think our cackle apples turned out perfectly pink. And I know you don't typically think of pink and green as a color scheme for Halloween, but you have to admit, these are super cute. And they are named after a character in one of my favorite Halloween movies from the 80s. So you might have noticed I did leave one of the apples naturally white, and I covered it with a little bit of pink sprinkles. And I did that because, you know, there are some families out there who just aren't there yet with eliminating food dyes from their kids' diet or from their own diet. So I thought this is a nice compromise. You still have the nice natural apple and the vegan white chocolate and a little bit of pink food coloring there. So a lot of bang for your buck, so to speak. I did wrap some of these apples up because the kids in my neighborhood, who I know, this is what they're getting when they come trick-or-treating to my house. All the other kids are getting that prepackaged stuff. I labeled it with my name so that when the parents get home at night, they know, oh, this is from my neighbor Crunchy Scott, so I'm sure it's safe and delicious. I'm also gonna label it vegan because a lot of families are going that route these days, and I think they'd really appreciate a trick-or-treat item that is completely vegan, healthy, and homemade. Long before Hogwarts, there was Miss Cackle's Academy for Witches. Now, The Worst Witch was a British flick, but it aired here in the US on HBO, which is how I saw it. But today, thanks to places like YouTube and the link I'll post below, you too can enjoy the retro awesomeness that is The Worst Witch. So make a batch of cackle apples for yourself, subscribe to my channel if you dare, and have a totally crunchy Halloween. So if you filthy smelly, evil, wicked, and cruel, you'll be right at home in my little school. It's in the movie. Check it out.